Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question by D. Thompson, who asks, would you know a good tool for building a gambrel roof? We're going to dive into that after the intro. So we're going to be using a plugin today called Instant Roof NUI. You can find it on the Extension Warehouse. It'll redirect you to another website where you'll actually have to pay for this. I couldn't find a free version of a roof tool that would do what you're asking for. You can obviously build it from scratch, and it's pretty easy to build, but if you're looking for instant roofs, this is, I think, the way to go. So I've just been using this, so I'm not an expert at using this plugin yet. It seems to work. I just don't know a lot about roofs and or haven't gone through all of the tutorials. So I think a combination of those things have made this kind of hard for me to make the roof. So, but I'm going to show you what I've learned and just how you can do it. So you see, obviously you need to select the area, the horizontal area that you want to turn into a roof. And then you also need to select the two gable ends. For this. So we have our area that we're covering and then the two gable ends. I'm going to select this make a roof option. When you click the make a roof option, it pops up this window, and then there is a library of styles you can actually click. You can go through them here if presets is selected, but there's also this visual sort of guide to help you select. So obviously you want this because we kind of want to do like a barn style roof. So I'm going to just select that, and you can see that it selects barn gable. If I was to select a different one, it would automatically reselect. So just a quick way to do that. If you want to edit the style, I don't really want to edit it too much, but yes, I want to edit this. Quality takeoff, you can get sort of like how many faces and everything you're creating. And then if you want to customize it, you just go to parameters here. Now, this is sort of like where I'm not sure what I'm doing, to be honest. Obviously, for slope, you want double. This slope here is the bottom slope, and then this slope is the upper. And then I'll show you what break at height is. Just remember that is 8 feet. And then roof underside, it's been sort of wonky when I've tried to do roof underside, so I'm not exactly sure what that's doing. Some of these things don't seem to be working 100% correctly, but again, I think that might be just because I'm not sure what I'm doing. So I'm not gonna fault the plugin because I didn't actually know how to make the gambrel roof at all. And I was like, this doesn't work. It's just making hipped roofs. And it's because I wasn't selecting those two edges. So I'm not gonna fault the plugin creator for this. I'm just gonna say it's probably my fault for not fully understanding how to do this before making the video. Because it seemed to work good when I knew what I was doing. So, but anyway, so you have all these parameters that you can change. Obviously, some of them aren't available. I'm not sure why that is. If there's like other options that need to be selected, like I can't select truss for some reason. Maybe if I select single roof. Yeah, then it seems like the truss becomes available. So you can't choose a truss for a double sloped roof. Apparently, I guess that's what's going on. So I'm just going to hit make a roof so you guys can see what's going on. Obviously, this isn't what I want. It's kind of funny looking, though. But if I choose the measure tool, so let's choose that. I'll just show you guys what's going on here. You can see that that is about 8 feet. I'm not exactly sure where it's cutting that from, so it could be a different spot. So let's just undo that. And then choose our tool again. Instead of 8 feet, let's choose, let's say 3. How about that? Make roof. So that's much better. And obviously, if you're making this shape, you would know what you're doing if you're making like a barn or something. So this is the plugin that I would recommend. I think it's kind of the only one if you want to do custom roofs that you can use. It does have rafters and things like that, so in theory it would make it a lot easier. It's just going to take some time getting to learn the plugin is what I'm assuming. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.